the Center for Chicano-Boricua Studies originated as the Latino in Marcha Leadership Training Program in 1971. It was established by Wayne State University, the Latin Americans for Social and Economic Development, and New Detroit Incorporated.
Chicano-Boricua Studies is the name of the center that was formerly the Latino in Marcha Leadership Training Program. That was a program that was organized back in 1971 to provide opportunities for working adults to get the type of training needed to function in society and make a change in society.
The Latino in Marcha Leadership Development Program is actually what later developed into the Center for Chicano-Boricua Studies. It's only one pillar of the four pillars of the center's mission, but it's sort of one of the big focal points, because that's how we get students here at the university, and that's how we get students into our classes. So basically, recruiting students to Wayne State, recruiting students to CBS, and making sure that they stay here and that they do well.
What we do here at CBS, we do so much, it's hard to put it all into one answer. I'm currently a office assistant here in the Center for Chicano-Boricua Studies main office. We do all kinds of things, from just little office tasks to helping with recruitment. Currently we're working on some student call lists and getting together an information night for the center to outreach to all kinds of incoming students who are really interested in becoming a part of the program. That's exciting for me because we get to do all kinds of stuff, from talking to students and parents all the way down to putting together all of the legwork of getting together student packages and making all the phone calls. It's really kind of an exciting time for the center.
Well, Center for Chicano-Boricua Studies has helped me a lot, because when I came in as a freshman, I didn't know what to expect, and the counselors were very friendly at Center for Chicano-Boricua Studies, and they practically took me under their wing. They said they helped me with my grades, they helped me erase them, because at first I didn't know what classes I was doing or what was I supposed to choose, and they helped me out a lot.
CBS was one of the first undergraduate academic programs for Latinos in the Midwest. We serve metropolitan Detroit through a multifaceted mission of student service programs, Latino advocacy on campus, community outreach, and research.
The program began basically when people began to realize that there was a gap in the leadership and in the educational realm in the community. And they were looking for ways to prepare people, students, to fill those gaps. So they got together with Latin Americans for Social and Economic Development and New Detroit. They, members of those two organizations, got together, and they decided to create the Latino in Marcha Leadership Training Program. From there, the program came to Wayne State, and it was received here. It received support from one faculty member, at least one that I know of, probably others. But the one that I remember of was Otto Feinstein, Dr. Otto Feinstein. And he lobbied within the inside of the university to make sure that this program was created.
The winter semester of 2004, Dr. Chinea knew that I was teaching in the English department. I was teaching composition, and he asked if we could have a meeting, and said that he was concerned about CBS students and how they're doing in the writing classes, and wanted to know if there's anything that we could do better in terms of helping our students pass their composition classes here at the university. And so he had the idea of doing something during the summer, and offered me a little bit of seed money to try to develop a summer program. And so the first year in 2004, it was actually called the Summer Writing Workshop. And so the Summer Writing Workshop, we enrolled about 8 students with the intent of creating a program that gave them a, sort of a head start, a look at what their 10-10 class would be like. Most of the students there was were scheduled, at least at the time, to have to take English 10-10 in the fall. 6 weeks, 2 days a week, gave them a little bit of a peek and a little bit of a taste of what 10-10 would be like. And I encouraged the students actually to retake their English placement exam. And a really nice thing that happened was about three of those students actually subsequently tested it at 10-20. And so just 6 weeks, meaning 2 days a week, they're actually able to skip an entire semester of writing because of what they learned.
The center recruits students into a two-year academic program designed to facilitate the transition between high school and college and to increase retention. It also provides support services for students not formally in the program.
The summer of 2005, it was still called the Summer Writing Workshop. But Dr. Jorge Prosperi came on to talk a little bit about critical thinking issues, especially ethnic identity, you know, the formation of self-identity. And we did some interesting things. We went to the DIA and looked at the Diego Rivera murals and did some team teaching where he would teach lessons on identity and self, and I would ask them to write about it. I'd help them with the essays that they're developing on self-formation and those kinds of things. It was last summer that we added a math component based on Dr. Andre Cortado's research on CVS and math interventions. We thought it was important to start addressing math because we were successful in addressing English, and we thought we could be just as successful in math, and we're starting to see with preliminary data that we were. So the program is expanding, and another part of the expansion is the addition of the peer mentors. So peer mentors came on for the first time in 2007, so we're very excited to have a non-residential pre-college summer bridge program.
Right now, currently, I teach the Student Success Seminar, which is a first year class for students who are making the transition from high school to the university. Part of the class teaches leadership development, researching skills, along with sort of self-empowerment, self-empowerment ideas and concepts, which are incorporated within the class so the students become more independent.
CVS has already started to help me in growing and maturing as not only a student but as a professional, and preparing me for, you know, after graduation. There's been many events that I've gone to thanks to CVS, Nishimba galas, dinners for other organizations, and I really have had the opportunity to network with so many other professional business people and get cards and phone numbers from people who I potentially could either land a job with, land a career with, or network with them through somebody else to get to where I need to be after graduation and even before then. Right now, I'm currently in the works of possibly getting a summer internship with a business, MTZ Industries. So that's going to benefit me as well. It gets me a little bit out of the university and then spreading my wings a little bit more. So I'm thankful for that.
I'm